charge your own device. But anyway, I'm looking forward to having a good time today, and I hope you are, and I think that's the reason you come, and we got some good music lined up. So I'm just going to turn it right over to the banjo in the hall, and I think Mr. Brown will probably introduce all his people.
Thank you so much. We're just happy to be here. It's fantastic. You got some good bluegrass music coming on this afternoon. You got rappers, Swift Run, and the Shady Grove Band. So you're in for a big treat, especially right here under the air conditioning. So sit back, enjoy yourself. I'm here to have a good time. We all will have a good time. We hope you do too. And with the crowd coming in, looks like this thing will be full here pretty shortly. So enjoy yourself. And first thing we want to do for you, one call someday. We'll meet again, sweetheart. Old Lance Scruggs, North. Enjoy the music. So I'm going to turn it over to Mike right now, let him tell you just a little bit about Banjo in the Hollow, because it's an interesting club. And we're members, we're not a regular band, but we get together and play at functions occasionally, and we've got a couple of rehearsals, and but we put together some songs we think you enjoy. Mike, tell us just a little bit about Banjo in the Hollow.
Back in about 1990, I went to what was called the Tennessee Banjo Institute. I play the banjo as well as the guitar. And I got my banjo batteries all charged up when I came back to Raleigh. I wanted to keep that feeling alive, so I started a club called Banjo in the Hollow. And it took off kind of slowly, had a few members to start with, but now, like Lindy was telling, we have members all over the world. A lot of the musicians that are playing in the other bands here today are members of Banjo in the Hollow as well. And Bill Tatum, standing over there, who's from Granville County, who helped put all this together, as a member of Banjo in the Hollow as well. So we're real pleased to be here today, and hope you all have a good time and enjoy the music. A lot of good bluegrass music coming up. Thanks a lot.
Okay. Thank you. I have a five-string banjo I've been playing with for about the last 5 years or so, and really enjoy his five-string playing, and we'll get him to kick this song off, one entitled Head Over Heels. him a tune that he likes to do, and like to hear him do it. One called, I think Flat and Scruggs, and a lot of people have done it, but Flat and Scruggs is a version that I think he liked very well. One called Little Girl of Mine in Tennessee. You ready for that, Mike? All right.
We're going to make it easy on me. We've been singing all these songs in the key of A. Now we're going to move down to the key of G. Make it a little bit easier on me. Thank you.
but he was having a big time dancing around up here. A little old bitty thing. I don't know how he got in here, but how about a big hand for Mr. Jeff Winkle back here on the sound? One of the best sound people around tonight. Thank you, Jeff. Jeff's quite a bluegrass musician himself. Saw him the other day up in Denton, North Carolina, doing the festival affair for the folks there. My job. We enjoyed it. Jeff. All right, let's move the show along now and pick another one for you. We're going to have to change some gears here. Y'all like corny jokes? You like corny jokes on Sunday? You do? Maybe these two guys were sitting out talking on Sunday morning and one of them was sniffing and all that kind of stuff. And he said, one said to the other one, says, "What's wrong with you?" He said, "Well, I got sinus trouble." You pronounce it wrong. "Did you mean sinus trouble?" He said, "Oh, no, since I was out with another girl, man, wife last night, he's seen us, so I got sinus trouble." I warned you, I told you it was going to be corny, but I didn't tell it anyway. The guys have been punching me in the back and saying, "Hey, get off of that stuff this Sunday morning." We got a guy over here that's doing some mighty fine singing on the dobro, and last night we were out playing a gig that happened to come by, and he did a tune that we kind of like. I wonder if I can get him to do it right now, one called Rocky Road Blues. How about it, Tap? Mr. Tap Turns on the dobro, if you will. How about a big hand for Tap? Song is just not right. We don't do another one, so we got another cabin song I want to do for you now. One called Little Cabin Home on the Hill.
There's only 47 left.
Yeah.
Sometimes I really miss that farm, too. Old tobacco farmers are down east of North Carolina, down below Greenville, Winterville, Aiden, that area. Anybody ever been down that way? Anybody been to Aiden, Greenville, and all that kind of stuff? They call it God's country down there. I married my wife from up in the mountains. We went down there. She said, my goodness, what happened to all the hills? They're gone. So, just don't have any hills down there. Everything is flat, and all the windstorms in March, when they come through, when you drive through, don't wash your car. But it just flies everywhere, all across the roads, just like fog out there across the road. So I sure did miss the farm. Go down every chance I get. My father plays music. He's still playing. He's 71 now, and mighty proud of him. Enjoy going down and seeing him. Got another tune here. That's a good tune. Feature Mr. Tab Curran, don't it? One called. Oh, he looked at me. I guess I won't sing anymore. You want to do another kind of thing? Let me do it for you, Dad.
Do it.
All right. Okay, he lost his voice on that other one. Screwed him to death, so give him a big hand anyway. But let me take just a moment and introduce the guy back here with the big bass in the middle. Sometimes these guys are the most, they really give you the backbone of your group, and when you're playing, you really need them, and sometimes they just don't get the recognition that they need, and we appreciate George here today. George Williamson on the big bass, if you will, give him a big hand. We thank you, George. Hang in there, buddy. One call, 9 pound count. Thank you. job. If you'll stand up, Donna, everybody give her a welcome, if you will. Thank you, Donna. Appreciate it very much. All right, I want to introduce a guy right over here who played five string banjo. As I mentioned earlier, I played with off and on, taught me a lot about music, bluegrass, and what have you, and I certainly appreciate it. It's just great to be up here picking with you, a guy by the name of Tom Garrett out of Cary, North Carolina.
He's been up here doing all the fronting for the band and talking and singing and picking around fine rhythm guitar, and I wouldn't tell you who he is. This is Lenny Brown from Raleigh.
Okay, we're going to take it out now with a tune that we like to do. I think everybody will like it. One called Sitting on Top of the World. Up in key of B-flat, so we're going to change gears on you right quick. This fast, so it won't take long to do it.
Oh, there. So we'll be telling you who we are along the way. We're going to try not to talk too much. And we're so glad to be here, so glad the United Bank sponsored this and the Arts Council. And Fidelity, I'm sorry, Fidelity Bank. Well, they went out to pay. But anyway, we appreciate you having us. And we're so glad to get out. We've been stuck in the studio since May and working on an album. And we just now got it through. And we're going to production next week. So if we play something you like and you know it's on the album, let us know. We'll make sure we take your name, make sure you get a copy of it. This next fellow, he and I kind of worked on this thing together. And he's a local boy, and we're going to go ahead and let him do his thing. I see his family's here, so they can go ahead and get the full effect. But this is a tune that he wrote about his grandfather, and it is on the album, and I hope you enjoy it. But please make welcome Clifton Freddy on the fiddle.
Is your home always known and laid you down? Many times we shared things, the times we came and came again, to let you know what was going on and what was on our mind. You'd always listen to what we heard. Never turn to say a word. Well, finding man on this earth, my friends, you'll never find. And sit, is your home boys, don't ever let it die. I work so hard to make it so. Lord knows I try. Made you love to provide. Here's your home, boy, please don't ever let it die.
Does a fine job. He's singing a tenor voice. He's playing the mandolin, and he's helping out a lot. And he's been a member of the band for a long time. And please make welcome. We're gonna send a team for you. Durham Moxley, sitting along with me. Good one. Give a big hand to us. on every album, bluegrass album, you gotta have a couple of instrumentals, and we had no problem picking out which one to do on this one. And it's one the Clifton really does a fine job fitting on. I'm glad somebody else. Anyway, this song I know you'll enjoy. You can pat your foot to it, your dances. If you want to dance to this, you'll have something to dance to. Called Panhandle Ride.
Since May, and I've really come to...
Since the dinosaurs
came. Yeah, it seemed like it. Really gotten to know his family a lot more in detail and everything. We've certainly learned a lot from doing this, and this is one that's on the album. It's called Uncle Jack, and if you listen to the words, it paints a pretty picture. It's one that you wrote. Please pay attention to the words.
You see him in the moonlight, walking down the road, homeless where he grew up, not far did he roam. Second son of the family of a man named Jones. He loved the country, the country was his home. Chose a baby to share. he made from the banjo. Him folks say he was quiet, they knew his banjo. We're down in Dixie, to the mountain shack. Man with the heart of gold, he's shooting for his back. As a boy, I remember, although I was mighty young. That's why I sing this song for Uncle Jack.
Tune about Dan's very unfortunate fourth marriage. It's called Imprisoned by Her Memories. The only member of the Shady Grove band ever to have eaten a live turtle. She sings the bass, and maybe that's her secret, actually. She sings the bass. I tell you, I just have to get up here. She plays the bass, but I'm thinking right now that maybe that turtle is the secret here, because she sings out of this world, doesn't she, folks? Please make welcome Ms. Adele Shin.
Over here on the mandolin, the other original member of the Shady Grove Band, He writes a lot of our original material, and we're mighty glad to have him with us. He's from Asheville, North Carolina. Please make welcome Mr. Charles Patty.
I'll tell you what, folks. He sings a mean mandolin. Well, anyway, we're going to do original tune that Adele wrote. We write a lot of our own music, as Adele mentioned, and we like the old traditional stuff too, but we write a lot of stuff because that's fun, and we hope you like it. We're going to do a waltz tune that Adele wrote, we recorded. Now, I know that we've mentioned we've recorded things a couple of times, and of course, that's a cheap ploy to make you buy our records and CDs, which of course we have for sale here in the lobby. If you'd like one of those after the show, of course, we'll fix you up. We'll get into that later, but anyway, in the meantime, I'm just killing time because the singing mandolin player is back there tuning. But anyway, here we go with one called the Cold Heart Waltz.
I wonder what you'd say if you knew I still love you, and I'm sorry you ever went away. Thank you.
banjo instrumental. You know, every bluegrass band has got to have a banjo instrumental. And this was written for you by the King of King here. And it's called the Donkey Punch, which is kind of an interesting thought, I guess, as long as you guys were up and dancing. Jason's got his own dance he's made up to this. Maybe he'll show it to you afterwards. He also told me that that he was going to nominate himself for a Grammy for this. So maybe you all would like to help him with that.
Can't spell nominate, though. That's the only problem.
I can't help it. So.
Thank you.
thanks, Jerry, for singing that. He was trying to get out of it, I think, but we're going to make him push him back up to his mic and get him the new one that we've about figured it out entirely, and we put it together and we've sent it up to Tom and Ray. That's Click and Clack, the Car Talk Brothers. How many are familiar with the Car Talk show on the radio? About three of you, I see. Four now.
It's a popular show, Charlie.
We're told it's a real popular show. We enjoy it. We suggest you listen to it. It's on. It comes on noon on Saturdays, I believe, on the National Public Radio, and it's funny. These people call in and tell them about their cars and what problem they might be having. They actually give very good advice, but first they give the caller a hard time. You know, they'll say, "Why on earth are you driving a 79 Vega? Don't you realize that's dangerous?" Blah blah blah. You know, it's not funny when I do it, but when they do it, it's really funny. And they tell folks how to fix their cars. And the show is called Car Talk, and we wrote a song for these guys to use as a theme song, and we sent it to them. And what?
That was about 6 years ago. We hadn't heard back from you.
I'm sure they like it though. No, we just sent it a few weeks ago, and we haven't heard anything yet. So my suggestion is that if any of you do listen to the show, is call and ask about the theme song. Ask them if they're going to play it. So it'll be your part. It'll be a folk festival kind of thing.
That's right. We'll share the royalty checks around.
Hard to split a penny, but anyway, so the tune is called Car Talk, and it sounds like this.
Call Tappy Brothers, call Click and Clack, diagnostic duo for your rattle track.
What's your problem?
Catch a little flag.
You don't like free advice. Broken, drive train smoking, oil burning, steam churning. Got no brakes and that running motor's driving the corners, backseat scars.
Call Tappy Brothers, talk Click and Clack, diagnostic duo for your rattle trap.
Tell them about your problem.
Catch a little flag.
You don't like free life. I'm just breaking in a brand new pair of shoes.
Shoes.